Anyway, I gotta tell the story. It's about my great father, Murray Moishe Schwartzman. It's true, but changed his name to Schwartz for reasons that nobody in the family was ever able to ascertain. Because it was no less Jewish than Schwartzman. He's like, here, I'll take off the yarmulke, but I still got the pants. It doesn't do that. Anyway, he was out walking his dog one day in New York, and he was 79 years old. And he sees his next door neighbor, who's this 30-year-old Italian guy. And he says to the guy, please don't park your car in front of my driveway. This is Queens, New York. You don't park your car in front of somebody's driveway. And apparently the guy got all uppity about it and said, and he called my grandfather a moron. My grandfather says, if you call me a moron one more time, I'm gonna belt you one. This is a 79-year-old guy. But this is a guy who was working in the shipyards when he was a young man, when being a Jew in the shipyards got the crap kicked out of you unless you could kick some crap of your own. So this was a tough fighter guy. And it did not rub off on me at all. I got picked on all the way through. You don't need to hear this. Anyway, so he says, if you call me a moron, I'm going to belt you one. And this 30-year-old Italian guy comes at my grandfather, who drops his dog leash, punches this guy right in the face, picks up the dog leash and walks back into the house. He says to Grandma, I belted him one! She's like, ay fay. Thought that was the end of it. It wasn't. The next day, there's a knock at the door, and there's a police officer with the next door neighbor serving my 79-year-old grandfather a summons to appear in court for assault. So, Moishe prepares very carefully for the court date. He stops shaving. He does not shave. He gets his oldest, rattiest clothes out of the basement that he hasn't worn in years. He gets a cane out of the closet that he hasn't used since he broke his leg and he was like 60. He puts on these old clothes. He doesn't wear a hat. He doesn't shower. He's all haggard. And he gets the cane and he hobbles into the courtroom. And the mediator looks at my grandfather. And he looks over at the 30-year-old Italian guy who's now wearing a suit. And he looks over at my grandfather. And he reads the complaint because he thinks he's mixed up the plaintiff and the defendant. Assault? Thanks, Grandpa, you're finished. You can wait outside. Oh. You! Brings the guy into his chamber, rings his ass out for half an hour. The guy comes out and looks at my grandfather and says, and I called you a moron. I wrote this for Grandpa. I presented it to him on his 60th wedding anniversary. Not long ago, on one fine day in Flushing, Queens, the month was May, a day with more than normal count of smog. The word went out to stay inside from Tel Aviv to Telluride, cause Moishe the kid was leashing up his dog. Well, he's a quiet man who loves his mutts, he loves him so, he drives him nuts, he's caring and he's given to a fall. But just watch out where you park your car, you just might end up at the bar and laying down a lawsuit for assault. Well, boy, friend, yippee-ki-yay, and you might say his hair is gray, but I'm telling you, he's got shtetl dust in his blood. Ask the Jew next to you. Well, Baruch Hu, and yippee-ki-yay, I'm telling you, he's an ornery Jew who knocks him flat and shut himself above. Well, on that day, he hit the drive, he saw his eyes just come alive, his jaw about nearly almost hit the floor. As you could tell just by the tread, the sides are green, top are red, this stagecoach was the Chevy from next door. Well, he sidled over to the guy and he let out with a pitted sigh and punched him till the joint was walking blind. And as final fertilizes flowers, mechanics had to work for hours, cause just when punching his wheels were misaligned. Well, Lord, baby, I always seem to turn to Elvis in this part of the song. You know, Elvis was part Jewish. It's true. Elvis was an eighth Jewish. I'm not kidding. That's why he was always doing this, because he was half circumcised. Whoa, nice. Well, what am I doing? What the hell are you? I'm telling you. Anything to get through choruses. I hate choruses. ADD. The doctor told me I had, oh look, a bunny. I How's that job doing over there, Freaks? I'm sure Bonnie Raitt was Freaks played for Bonnie Raitt for 10 years, right? So I'm sure, was she ADD-ish at all? Was she? Yeah.
She was just like you, Eric.
Let's give them something to talk about. All right. ADD. Okay, never mind. I won't sing the same song for 4 years. That voice that kid just tarried there with his neighbor in intensive care as a 747 crossed the moon. Stopped the saver in the midnight smog, and he whistled out to his trusty dog, and he stepped back in his very own saloon. If you want to try your hand and be the baddest in the land, don't say I didn't warn you, because I did. And remember, please, that fateful day when that sorry soul got towed away for parking in the path of Moishe the kid. Everybody, well, boy, baby. You're not being Mike, so it really doesn't matter. Well,